Well, it looks like old man winter's finally starting to pop out. You know, we had rain this morning. It was like 40 degrees this morning, and all of a sudden, temperatures started shooting down, and now we're probably in the upper 20s with snow coming, and it's blowing all around, and old man winter said, you know what? I'm off of vacation. I'm here, and it's time to get nasty. So, how is everybody doing tonight? I didn't really give anybody the proper hello today. And I want to give out what I think are the most likely things to happen in 2016. These are the banger predictions, and I'm not saying all these are going to happen. No, and by no means am I saying all this is going to happen. What I'm saying is these are the most likely things to happen in 2016. That's all I'm saying. Don't think I'm being Nostradamus or anything and I'm going, this is what's going to happen. And if none of these things happen, or if some of these things happen, or if all of these things happen, don't think I'm some kind of prophet or I'm an idiot. I'm just saying this is what I see happening, going on in the world. These are the most likely things because of where we're at in the world. Okay, so number 10, the most likely, the 10th most likely thing, which actually means the least likely of my 10 predictions for 2016. The U.S. and ISIS connection will be exposed to the world, and if that happens, it'll be to take out the U.S. for any influence they have across the world, and it'll trigger World War III anyways, but it'll be to take out the last vestige of influence the U.S. has on the world, which has been slowly disintegrating since at least the Bill Clinton eras, but for sure the George Bush eras and President B.O.'s era. The 9th most likely thing to happen here in 2016, and this is a sports prediction, and I know most of the people that listen to me, watch me on YouTube, don't get into sports. That's not why they come to see me, but I wanted to get this out there because I'm a hockey guy, and I think the 9th most likely thing to happen in 2016 is the Montreal Canadiens winning the Stanley Cup, beating the LA Kings in 6 games. That's right, beating the LA Kings in 6 games. Who knows, right? That's my sports prediction. The 8th most likely thing to happen in 2016, and this makes me very sad because I don't want it to happen, but I think it's going to happen. And that's AC/DC is going to announce their retirement. And I'm going to be bold on this one. They're going to do it right around July 9th. That's almost the end of their tour. And that's also Bon Scott's birthday. Just a guess. Not saying it's 100% going to happen. I'm saying it's a very likely thing for 2016. If I get that one right, you guys better give me kudos because that was some research I did on that one. The 7th most likely thing that I see happening in 2016, Donald Trump will be sacrificed by the establishment and Hillary Clinton will be the next president. Now, what do I mean, sacrificed? That could be a lot of things. It could mean that the Republican Party decides to not back Donald Trump and pick somebody else, forcing him to go third party. That could mean that the Democrats rig the election, the elites, the Democrats, all that, rig the election, the establishment, because Donald's got the support of a lot of people. And that lot of people aren't exactly backing the establishment. Or it could be, an assassination attempt. I've been thinking about this. Because if you take out Donald, then you got to have a secondary guy in the Republican Party take it, and there's nobody there that's even close to Donald. That's the seventh most likely thing. I'm not saying it's going to happen, but I'm betting on it that it's the seventh most likely thing to happen. At number six, Russia will invade Turkey. There's been a lot of tension there, and something may set off some triggers to where Russia will feel like they're going to have to get into Turkey to take care of ISIS. Remember, there is a connection there between Turkey and ISIS. Turkey's getting oil through the black market of ISIS, and that's how ISIS is funding their military operations, their government. So that's number six. Get me a drink. I got to get some coffee right now. I mean, this is very important, this stuff right here. And I got to be able to speak properly and not have dry mouth. The fifth most likely thing, ladies and gentlemen. And now we're getting into things that I think there's almost no doubt they're going to happen. We're getting really close. Any of these things could happen at any time. The U.S., this is the fifth most likely thing. The U.S. will have close calls with either China or Russian military, even to the extent of possibly exchanging fire. Which, of course, could trigger World War III. And with tensions being high between all those sides, and the increased surveillance and operations of all sides into near the other's territories. Everybody's encroaching, checking out what are these guys doing. So that I think that's an extremely likely scenario that will happen in 2016. This one's a little outside the box, and you're going to have to really pay attention to this one. Because this is a key here. We're going to see, this is number four, fourth most likely thing, and I think I'm right on target on this one. You're going to see President Obama positioning himself to be the Secretary General of the United Nations. You're already starting to see those signs. He's been kind of setting himself up the last year, and we're going to see it increasingly be more evident that he is doing this. And unless he finds a way to stay in office, which I can't see a likely scenario unless something big happens right around the election, and then he can only hold off the election for a little while before the people get mad. He's looking to his future, and I think the next step for him, which he, in his mind, because he's a globalist, the next step for him, the only thing higher than the United States president is Secretary General of the United Nations, because he gets to be the president of the world, so to speak. In case the aliens come and get us, he can be there going, let me be clear. We don't want war with you. What do you need? You know, that's what he'll do, is sell us out. All right, moving on. Number three. And I don't think this is some big revelation. I think a lot of people are predicting this. We're going to see more and more mass shootings and then talk of gun control to go along with it. The numbers of these mass shootings have increased. They continue to increase. We see them more often. So with the trend of the frequency of these shootings happening on the uptick, 2016 could be the bloodiest year in American history when it comes to mass shootings. which will allow the controllers the opportunity, because they can't let a crisis go to waste, it'll allow the controllers the opportunity to try, at least, their little ploy for gun control, which incrementally they've been doing anyways. Obama's new executive orders. We've got to get rid of those. Number two. This one is almost certain in my eyes. I believe a lot of people will agree with me on this. A major, and I mean major, terrorist attack inside the United States will happen. And it'll be somewhere. It could happen in LA and New York. That's the likely targets. But I'm thinking it's going to be something so horrendous. I think back to the Civil War comic book. You know, in Marvel Universe, where this guy blows up a neighborhood and a bunch of kids get killed. For some reason, that's what I'm seeing. They've tried the knocking down the towers and bombing the marathons. They've tried all that. Hasn't gotten the guns out of our hands yet. Something more horrendous needs to happen. Now, is it a nuclear attack? Because that would be more horrendous. Is it what I was talking about, like what happened in the Civil War comic book series, where a bunch of kids and, you know, like a little town gets blown up. Just blown up. A town, you know. I think that's an extremely likely scenario that could happen in 2016. They need to get the guns out of our hands. They need their final bit of control over us. And the bad guys who do it, who they allow, somehow they know who all the bad guys are. You can go look at, but they still get through every once in a while, even though they've been watching them. Somehow they get through and do their dirty deed. I don't know. All right. And the final, the number one, the most likely thing to happen in 2016. I think there's no doubt about it. All the signs are there. We can see it before our eyes. The economy is going to continue to tumble into recession, if not depression. And I don't mean the U.S. economy. I'm speaking the entire world economy, the global financial crisis that is happening all over the world. It's crumbling before our eyes. China, Wall Street, 94 million Americans not in the workforce. They've been lying this whole time about how many people are unemployed. Everything is so fragile as it is. And if it were to implode, which we're starting to see the signs, go look back to 2008. Don't believe me. Listen to George Soros, who's saying it's on the horizon. Go look at the experts that said that if Janet Yellen raises the interest rates, it was going to cause economic turmoil. Boom. And she went ahead and did it, knowing full well it was going to happen. These experts in the world can't see that whatever they're doing is going to cause this stuff. They can see it. They like seeing it. And it's on purpose. Because people like George Soros makes money when everything goes bad. So that's it. The number one thing, the most likely thing, is that we head into full-blown recession or depression. So come back to me next year. Ridicule me if I got them all wrong. Ridicule the heck out of me. I don't want any praise if I got any of these things right, because for the most part, all this stuff is bad, and I hate the idea that I'm right about the bad stuff. So please, I don't want any recognition saying, oh my God, John predicted this. You know, do you think William Cooper was proud that he predicted that Osama bin Laden would be blamed for the terrorist attacks that happened in New York? He wasn't proud of that. That is not something he would have rather been wrong. And I'm hoping I'm wrong on all these. That's the last, this is the last, anything that happens on my list here. This is the last thing this world needs right now. So I don't want praise if I get any of these right. And if you want to ridicule me, if you want to thumbs me down, if you don't think any of these are right, please thumbs me down, you know, if you're on YouTube. Of course, if you're listening to this on my radio show, you can't thumbs me down, but you can come to the chat room and make fun of me. We have a chat room. Come on in. Go down there and type away. It's cool. But 2016 doesn't look like it's going to be a great year when it comes to the terms of the entire world scope of things. Everything, the global geopolitical world is in turmoil. The financial world is in turmoil. Individuals are in turmoil. All right, I'm going to take a quick break, ladies and gentlemen. When we come back, I'll see how much time we got. Maybe we'll spend a few minutes on the Oregon rancher situation, and we're going to try to slide in a little bit of Donald Trump and Hillary Clinton, because we got to talk about the presidency that is up for grabs, and those are the two best the establishment can give us.